The second brain is a relatively new productivity system created by Tiago Forte with one basic premise that is similar to David Allen's line of thinking about ideas. Our brains are for having ideas, not storing them. In the past few months, I have found a new level of mental clarity ever since I started applying this concept to my productivity systems. Well, it started with a journal and a capture inbox for tasks and a place to put all of my content and system improvement ideas. I wanted to take things a step further. I thought to myself, what if I could create a second brain that would be the perfect place to capture all of my ideas and make the most out of them? I'll be honest, as a creative, I think I may have needed this more than I'm willing to admit. And what I probably am not willing to admit as well is how shameless I'm going to ask you guys to hit that like button, subscribe, and hit the notification bell to stay up to date with all of my latest videos. In all seriousness, the second brain is a system that I really want to utilize to capture everything. I've talked about putting down your meals and what you've planned before and what to prep. I've talked about resonance calendars, I've talked about capture inboxes. And the whole point of the second brain is taking every idea that you have and capturing it and then synthesizing it into tangible action items or places that you can keep resources. And as of recently, I've been getting a lot of ideas, not only through the various content that I'm thinking about creating and just my day-to-day life, but I've been reading a lot from my new Amazon Kindle Paperwhite. And I've been reading the book Courage is Calling. And during that process, a lot of different books that I may want to read have crossed my mind. So as I talk about productivity on this channel a lot, we all want to learn much more than we have the time for. And for me, I can't waste my time just going and reading a book that probably isn't going to fit my taste. And that's where Shortform comes in. Shortform makes the best nonfiction book summaries on various types of content. I, for one, am a fan of self-improvement, productivity, and entrepreneurship books, and Shortform is like book reviews on steroids. They make absolutely amazing book reviews.
I actually used Shortform recently to check out the one-page review on the book Principles by Ray Dalio. What the nice thing was about this one-page summary is that it gave me a very great baseline of understanding what this book is about and what Ray Dalio believes regarding how every situation has happened before and his thought process and how you can systemize decision-making and make it more objective and efficient. As a productivity geek, I already know that this is going to be a book that I'm very much going to be into. Another great thing about Shortform is the fact that every single week, Shortform publishes new guides and articles that the subscribers actually get to vote on. So if you have a subscription, you essentially have a voice in what books you want to be reviewed.
And the nice thing about this app in comparison to something like Blinkist, which I've been hearing a lot about, is the fact that you can do a one pager and see that review in that sense. You can see a 10 minute overview and you have a lot of different options in comparison to Blinkist, which is a little more stagnant in what they have for you. To get a 5-day free trial, make sure to click that link, shortform.com/Dimitri, in the description down below, and you'll be able to access all of Shortform's amazing book reviews there. Thank you again, Shortform, for sponsoring this video. Let's dive into my Notion workspace and show you how I capture everything with my second brain.
First and foremost, the reason I made this is because with all everything being interconnected in one place rather than having all of these separate center parts here, I can kind of go through my life and recycle ideas and circle back to previous ideas that maybe I thought weren't good at the time. You know, they came up, I thought they were good, now that they weren't. This whole system is kind of based off of the PARA or PARA system, and I kind of differentiated a little bit, but essentially a PARA system has project, area of responsibility, resource, and archive. So my sections here are content ideas, which essentially connects to projects, system improvements, which is an area of responsibility, resonance calendar, which is a resource, projects and tasks, obviously projects, and then life, which is more of a resource center. So all of these are different life buckets. And the way that I have everything set up, if I open up one of these here and I look at the properties, first and foremost, it has it filtered to the created time, which kind of helps me with some organizational stuff and for reference as to when I had this idea. Funny, I had this idea at 4:56 this morning. I get up at 4:30 now. I have this equation that is a status checkbox. It's a Boolean based off of a bunch of other Booleans. And then there is an idea bucket. So this is kind of the main first layer, right? So when you take an idea bucket, you can kind of look at this and see that there's the content idea, system improvements, resonance calendar, projects and tasks in life. And then what the differentiator below is essentially the idea bucket. And the second layer of everything is this sub bucket. So the sub bucket is essentially what is this about rather than what is this for. So if it's a YouTube content idea, that is inherently different than a YouTube system improvement and different than a YouTube video that resonated with me and different than a project and different than life. So where is this coming from and or what and sort of what sub bucket does it lie under? And then tags are just a bunch of different tags regarding like this very specific nitty gritty stuff about it. And we obviously can have things like URL and files and whatnot so that we can keep things a little bit more streamlined. So essentially what this status is essentially how I get my archive going and how I have a lot of the filtering automated. So when it comes to this, so you can see this YouTube video, let's say I made a video or connected this to a video, why everything needs to change. Okay, that's an old video of mine, but anyways, so you can see it's a status Boolean equation. If property, the YouTube relation, is empty, then it's false. And if it's not empty, then it's true, which made it checked off by when I did that. So essentially what I went through and did was made anything that this is connected to, my second brain is connected to my YouTube videos, my podcast episodes, my task and event calendar, my book library. It very well could be connected to my food calendar shortly, or my food planner. And moving forward with that idea, if you take a formula like this and have a bunch of ORs, you can connect all of these together to make one big, essentially OR function that figures out, okay, are any of these checked off? If that's the case, then it's checked off. If not, then it's not checked off. And then when I go through the filtering process here, with the second brain system, I can see what's been used and what hasn't been used. And I could take that on a granular level or an overall level. And the granular level would be is if I would set this status, YouTube is not checked, but instead I just have it for status for everything. So essentially if anything is used and connected to anything else, it will disappear from the main views that I have. So as you see here, if I did something like this, my minimalist everyday carry, and I literally just made a new one, that disappeared from that page there, right? Now I don't want to do that yet. I don't have an idea about that, but if I delete this, then it comes back. And all of these different headings and stuff like that and different pages are essentially just filtered out to the idea bucket, and then they're broken out for a further level. And a nice way that I'm able to capture everything is in a few places. And a big reason that it's easy to do this is because the grouping feature in Notion is so great. So first and foremost, I can go to something like my daily planner, which has that same grouping view there. So if I go to my daily planner, essentially I have this grouped view made that is filtered to what has been created in the past week, and the status is not checked off. So anything, there's nothing related to anything else here. And as you can see, it's really nice that you can untoggle these and see what's been created in the past week. And it's easy to capture these by pressing new page. So for example, I could have a system improvement idea, or I could have a content idea. So if I do YouTube video idea, why I wake up at 4 a.m., and then I could put a tag on this guy. Okay, probably productivity, the sub bucket. I had a template made out that already had like YouTube ideas and whatnot. If I press delete here, you can see there's system improvements, podcast topic idea, resonance content, just stuff like this to at least get the sub bucket or the idea bucket figured out, and then some sub buckets for those as well. But I can quickly capture any of these. I can also go to here, which is my main second brain page. It has the same view, and there's the group view and the non-grouped view. So essentially it shows, okay, everything together and then everything separate. I like it to have it grouped. And lastly, what I can do is I can go into my daily journal entry. So there's not gonna be much for this entry, but essentially at the top of every journal entry, you can see there is a second brain spot that is filtered to created time is today. So I can quickly jot down any ideas that I'm having during a journal session in my second brain. The whole concept of it is that I want to be able to capture everything and then synthesize it, you know, take action and archive things. So all that is the breakdown of essentially what each part of this is and where you can capture things quickly. The next question is, how can I take action on this? So if I see the system improvements page, you can see I kind of have it broken out into, you know, what schedule improvements can I make? What setup and organization can I improve on? What YouTube aspects can I improve, etc. And what I usually have every single week is a system improvement section. So what I used to do prior is actually take the system improvements ideas that I had, and I would go and I would type them out, and I'll show you an example here. So if I go here, I would just literally type them out throughout the week, and that's great. And I would maybe reference my journal sometimes, and that's whatever. But none of this is ever documented in a database, and I wasn't really a fan of that. So essentially what I did was I improved this by going through, and if we take this most recent template, is now this is connected to my second brain, where basically it's filtered so that idea bucket is system improvements and is created within the past month, and the status is not checked off. So if this gets connected to the task and event calendar, it'll disappear. And it's very easy then to have it documented. When was this improvement made in a database form? And then I can also just quickly in the system improvement section, after it's documented in the database, go through and do a similar process. And I can also do the same thing with my journal entries. But essentially what I'm then doing is I'm taking action each week on ideas that I'm jotting down, looking at them and seeing what ideas from this week were good, what can I take action on, and in what ways can I improve my systems each and every week. And the same will end up happening for my content ideas as well. Now, if we then go to this page, which is content ideas, we can kind of look at this from a YouTube perspective. And what's nice is I have a bunch of different filters here, so I can take, you know, my overall unused ideas and get a look at this and see, all right, what kind of videos can I make this week based on this stuff? Or I can go to the apps one specifically, like I know that I want to make a few app videos a week. And then outside of that, like more of the formal style, which is it's like filtered to, it's not an app one, it's not a vlog one, it's not a 30-day challenge one, but it is a YouTube video. And the same goes for, you know, when I'm doing podcasts, I'm thinking like, all right, when we're looking to do new book reviews, now it's filtered. So this idea is a content idea. The tag contains book, it is, and the sub bucket's podcast. So I can go through this and see in a lot of different senses. So if I go to the podcast project planner, we have to think of some ideas for future ones. So we did Yoga for 30 Days, it's coming out today. We want to probably review Courage is Calling, Fortune Favors the Brave. However, what can I do for next week? So if we look at this, I feel like we could talk about, so if we go through and look at the productivity ones or the philosophy ones, I feel like it'd be good to talk about ethical automations. So if I look at what Chance's notes were, applications that automate donations to charity, Echo Chart. Okay. So if I go through and I take this, right, and I just literally copy the title, go in here, I have a project template for podcast. So if I go to Second Brain, paste in the name, right? And if you really want to make sure it's the right one, you could always paste the link. So obviously this is the right one. So we have ethical automations. Let's say this is going to be released in 2 weeks. It's an idea. It'd be podcast number 71. It's going to be a philosophy tag. And then we can do this for stuff like YouTube videos as well. And as you can see, when I go back here, the ethical automations is checked off, and that means it disappears from this area. So we've taken action on things in the second brain rather than just capturing a bunch of ideas and not doing anything about it. So then you might be asking, well, what am I gonna do when all this stuff disappears from the various views? Well, that's why you have the all ideas areas of these, as well as you can go through and filter stuff in the big actual database, because those are a bunch of related databases that were just pasted. And you can filter it to different buckets here. So for here, I just have my second brain set up to like literally have the PARA system. So projects being content ideas and projects and tasks, and they're filtered to not being checked off. Areas of responsibility right now is just system improvements and not checked off. Resources is residence, calendar, and life and not checked off. And then furthering that with the archive, right? So the archive in this sense would be literally everything where the status is checked off. So we can see all the old stuff, like, all right, literally everything has been put somewhere, right? And it's checked off. And then the last part being stuff that is and isn't checked off here. What is and isn't archived. And I wanted to have it set up so that it auto does the archiving, because I had it set up, and as you can see, there's a property in here called status old, where it's like showing what the idea segment was, and I would manually change it to archived. However, I'm like, ah, I don't really like the fact that it does that. It's kind of taking a bit of the work and putting it the onus on the person, and I'm not a fan of that personally, and I would rather have it auto do it. So essentially, you can go through and look at different things in different views by just making relations. Capturing everything is important, but organizing the information and making weekly checkpoints where you can synthesize the information and take what you're learning and utilize it to the best of your ability, it really helps. And something that's nice for me, and something I want to just dive into for a second, is the fact that you can take things like information that people give you on a random daily basis. So people tell me movies and TV shows now. I just drop this in here thinking, oh, this is like the next movie I want to watch. I see TV shows like Ghost looks good, Squid Games look good, food, like different places that maybe I want to go to eat, restaurants, all those kind of things. Life, just like dreamline ideas, like I want to go live in a camper and like travel across this country. I can write that in there. And this is all organized so that whenever you have an idea, at least it's somewhere and you don't lose it.
So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. It was a little bit more in depth than maybe some of my other ones regarding the type of like databases I have. And it's a little convoluted. There's some equations in there. I haven't made a template with equations yet. So if you like this one, you can go check this template out at riseproductive.com/templates. And if you want to keep up to date with everything going on in my life, also make sure to subscribe to my email newsletter, The Saturday Sum Up. In the Saturday Sum Up, you can find a weekly kind of, I don't know, it's like a refresh of all the videos I made of the week, as well as a talk on a topic that kind of came to mind. And it's almost like a blurby blog post that has some quotes, some references, and some other things about what content I've enjoyed listening to this week. So with that being said, thank you guys so much for watching this video, and I will see you guys in the next one.